Collins, any word on survivors?
We've located numerous safe rooms with survivors inside. We're waiting on HRAs before we open. Once we can safely bring them out, let's try to escort.
It's bad, but we can handle it. Just like we handled that altered item making everyone drown themselves in the toilets.
So August 4th, 1964. We discovered the oldest house while investigating a suspected altered world event case in the New York City subway tunnels. The agents found their way up into the building. Once we became aware of it, it was there. Hiding in plain sight. A slippery blind spot, seemingly discouraging observation. It's a place of power. An ongoing AWE of its own, seemingly adhering to its physical outer constraints and yet constantly breaking the known boundaries of reality. It's unstable, shifting. Note, for more details on control points and the research and process to stabilize and secure the core sectors, refer to a separate presentation. After extensive research and investigation, the Bureau made the building its headquarters on November 13th, 1968. The Federal Bureau of Control was never out in the open. This was always an obfuscated, classified top secret operation. So imagine our surprise when the building's observation resistant aspects began in some unquantifiable way to affect the Bureau as a whole.
P6 is what the Bureau calls Dylan. His cell's been breached. Has the Hiss found him? Are you there with him? Can you protect him?
Ah!
been a long time since Dylan and I knew each other. I've wondered about him, what kind of man he'd grow up to be, were things as hard for him as they were for me. Maybe in here, they were even harder.
Is there something I can help you with?
I'm Jesse, the new director. I need to get inside.
New director? Right. Well, okay. Hello, I'm Frederick Langston, the Panopticon supervisor. It's not the best time for a tour. We have hiss everywhere, numerous cell breaches, and system failures across the board, but you're the director, so here we go. Founded by Zachariah Trench, the Panopticon is our state-of-the-art repository for all altered items.
I don't have time for this.
Power and...
I was told Dylan Faden was kept here. Can you help me find him?
Faden? Sure. Darling wanted him somewhere secure and isolated, away from people. He's in the maximum security cells, upper level. But there's currently a pressing matter, ma'am. We've got an object of power loose in there. It's wrecking the place. The Benikoff TV? It's a real doozy. Salvador took a team in to handle it, but no one's heard from them for hours. This is a Category 5 OOP we're talking about, and if we don't contain it soon, it will tear the Panopticon apart. And we don't want all those altered items getting loose, ma'am. No, trust me.
Dylan's in there.
Open the door, Langston. I'll handle it.
If you say so. I usually tell first-timers not to touch anything, so, just do that. Here, I'll get the door for you. And please, ma'am, call me Fred.
Thanks, Langston.
Can we provide any assistance at this time, sir?
Only if you can reboot the cell door protocols without manually accessing them.
Sir, we are not capable of completing that task. Please assign us a different task.
Why are you talking like that? You know what? Never mind. I'll take care of it.
The Panopticon. Dylan's close. But that object of power might wreck this place before I find him. Something went wrong with the Bureau's plan to make Dylan the next director. Marshall made it sound like it was all Dylan's fault, but how much of it was what the Bureau did to him? I don't think she's telling me everything.
Thank you. Hello? Is anyone there?
What are you doing in there?
Oh, thank God. Look, someone has to watch this object at all times, or it deviates. My shift replacement never showed up. Can you help me?
Damn. I can't, I'm sorry. There's an emergency. I'll come back, I promise.
Okay, just don't forget. I can't stare at this thing much longer.
That's the object of power. I need to cleanse it.
Yeah. I'm not going to promote.
out with the TV. Now I can find Dylan. Dylan.
Thank you. Hello? Can you hear me? Jesse. Are you there, Jesse?
Emily? He's gone. Dylan isn't here. He might be nearby. Or maybe the hiss got to him. I don't know.
Jesse, listen. Dylan's here. With us. He just walked in. He says he is giving himself up. He's been affected by the hiss, but he is different than the others. We must isolate him.
I'm on my way. We need to get back. I have to see my brother.
I won't take up too much of your time today, Dylan. Like I said, I want to talk about Jessie, your sister.
What about her?
I just want to get your perspective. What do you think of her? What kind of person is she? That sort of thing.
I adored my sister. When I was little, I mean. Back in ordinary.
And you don't anymore?
When I first got here, sure. I'd always hoped she'd come too. Find me, to take me home. We went everywhere together. Why should this be any different? Casper said she could come too, to the Bureau, if she wanted to. But she never did.
Why do you think that is?
Because she didn't care about me. She always wanted to be out on her own, seeing the world. She always said so. I guess she got what she wanted.
Right. So, she wanted to see the world. Did she ever mention any place in particular?
Why?
We like to ask questions around here.
I don't know.
What about that?
eyes open.
Hey, what can I do?
Oh, you're back. Oh, thank you. Thank you. If I look away, I don't know what this thing will do. You have to get me out of here. The door can only be opened by the Panopticon supervisor. That's Langston, if he's still around.
Langston. Yeah, I know him. I'll go ask him how to get you out.
Please hurry. My eyes. They can't. They can't.
Hey, calm down. Just focus. What's your name?
Focus. Right. My name's Philip, and I think I can hold on for a bit. It's just my eyes. My eyes hurt so much.
Just hang on, Philip.
There's someone named Philip up in a cell. He's watching a refrigerator and very rapidly losing it.
Philip? Oh shit, I forgot about fridge duty. He's been in there for over a day, I totally forgot.
You forgot about him?
There's a lot going on. The hiss, the Benikoff TV. Considering the number of things I'm juggling, ma'am, I think it's—
Listen, it's fine. We just need to get him out of there. He said you'd be able to open the cell door.
Yeah, I can unlock it on my terminal. There. Done. Door open. But Philip can't just leave. The fridge is behaving erratically. Ocular contact is the only thing that seems to placate it. If we don't have someone in there watching it 24/7, people will die.
I'll figure something out. I'm pretty good with these things.
Being pretty good with altered items isn't standard bureau procedure, ma'am.
He doesn't know us very well.
I'll see you later, Langston.
I'll be here, like always.
Like the board, but I can't understand it. Fuck?
Thank you.
Black Pyramid here. The fridge seems fixed. Did fighting that thing off change something?
Salvador, it was dangerous, but no. Why listen to that? How'd it go? Where's Philip?
Philip's gone. Something happened before I could get him out.
Poor Philip. He never did like fridge duty. But if you're here, then who's watching the fridge?
The fridge is fine now. I took care of it.
You don't just take care of altered items. What did you do?
I touched it and wound up in the astral plane. This thing was in there. It was huge, had one big eye. Wasn't friendly.
We've been getting reports from the astronauts lately about something fitting that description. The astral plane is usually connected to our world through objects of power, not altered items. If this thing is linking itself to altered items, then it's clearly powerful. This may happen again.
Do you think that thing is what got Philip?
Must have been. The Panopticon is a dangerous place. The agents all know the risks. But since you're some sort of altered item whisperer, I've got a list of others for you to corral. The hiss are causing containment breaches left, right, and center. Here, start with these. I'll see if there are any others missing while you're gone. My life just got a whole lot easier.
Do you like working at the FBC?
Sure. I mean, yeah, the drama's a bit much, but I get better benefits here than I would over at the Postal Service. I checked. Better healthcare. That's not to say I don't like my job, ma'am. Been here over 15 years. No one knows the Panopticon collection better than me. I'm, close to them, in a way.
I can't tell if that's creepy or normal here.
How do you keep the altered items under control?
It depends on the item. Each one has different needs. Ritualistic touches go a long way. Singing to them.
Did he say singing?
Flipping the lights three times, that sort of thing. It's not superstition if it works.
What's the difference between objects of power and altered items?
Think of them like storms. Objects of power are like tropical cyclones or hurricanes for the uneducated. They're big, rare, and scary. Of course, directors can just bind the OOP and become the eye of the storm. Altered items are more like weird thunderstorms. Some may rain frogs, some may rain corn, but they all rain something.
And how does the hiss factor into all that?
It's changing them, making them aggressive. Now they're all raining, I don't know, knives. Knife rain.
Nice metaphor.
Did you work closely with Trench?
Oh, he spent most of his time with Darling and all them. The inner circle. Not that I care.
Trench certainly had his favorites.
He did stop in occasionally to scowl and smoke. Did you know the Bureau has a no-smoking policy? It does. Just not for Trench. Still, he is the one who put aside funding for the Panopticon. The man did have vision.
How did you get this job?
Started as a junior agent because my uncle knew a guy. From there, I got put on a desk until an accident left the containment sector severely understaffed. At which point, I got bumped up to management. Put in a steady 8 hours a day for another 10 years, and voila, supervisor.
I just picked up a gun. Or a gun picked me.
I'll see you later, Langston.
I'll be here, like always.